بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله، صلى الله عليك وعلى أهل بيتك المظلومين، صلى الله عليك يا مولاي يا وابن مولاي يا أبا عبد الله، يا شهيد يا غريب يا مظلوم كربلاء، يا ليتنا فنفوز فوزا عظيما.
Brother Ali, will they dim the lights later? Will they dim the lights? When I get into the musibah, let them dim the lights, okay? Inshallah.
Enlighten your hearts and majalis with a loud salawat for Muhammad and Al Muhammad. On the day of Ashura, Al-Imam Al-Husayn alayhi salam was killed. Al-Imam Al-Husayn alayhi salam was killed on that day. His companions were all killed on the day of Ashura. Nothing remained of them except their bloody bodies, their beheaded bodies. As for their bodies, they were all beheaded. They all laid on the sands of Karbala without any ghusl, without any kafan, without any burial for 3 days. And as for the heads of Hussein and Abbas and the other companions, they were all placed on spears and lifted. But for Imam Hussein and his companions, the day of Ashura was the end of their tragedies, because they moved on to the next life. And they were at comfort with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the day of Ashura was not the end of tragedies for Ahlul Bayt. In fact, for Bibi Zainab alayha salam, for the woman of Rasulullah, for the orphans, the day of Ashura, when Imam Hussein was killed, that was only the beginning of their masa'ib, of their tragedies, of their trials and tribulations and problems. You find many of us, when the day of Ashura finishes on a day like tomorrow, that's it. We act like the masa'ib are over. We take off our black clothes. We don't come anymore. While the day of Ashura shouldn't be the end, brothers and sisters. The day of Ashura is the beginning. On a day like today, on a night like tonight, Zainab alayha salam had no Hussein, no Abbas. Zainab was treated like a slave. Zainab. Now until Sham, until a month from now, Zainab was taken with Imam Zainul Abideen and all the other women and the orphans, they were taken as slaves, as prisoners of war. These are the days of Masa'ib, brothers and sisters. This is when the Masa'ib started. That's why they call Zainab Ummul Masa'ib. She's the mother of Masa'ib, meaning she had to bear so much tragedy, so much calamities that befell her. First of all, Zainab had to witness what happened to her. She had to witness the martyrdom of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Some of us, we just hear the story of Hussein and how sad that makes us. Imagine if you witness seeing Hussein alayhi salam on the day of Ashura being killed by those enemies. She saw Al-Abbas being killed, Qasim, Ali al-Akbar, all of them. She lived with those memories. So first of all, she had to grieve for all her loved ones, Hussein and Abbas. When you lose a loved one, you want to sit down for at least a month, 2 months, especially when they're killed in that way, just to grieve, just to mourn, just to cry, just to lament. But every time late, Zainab would cry, you know what they would do to her? Shimr would come and he would whip Zainab alayhi salam. They were not allowed to cry. Zainab was not allowed to cry for Hussein and Abbas. So on top of all the tragedies that she saw, they did not allow her to cry, to mourn Imam Hussein and Abbas. All the calamities that fell on her. Now Shimr would come, he would curse Imam Ali and Fatima in front of her, and he would hit her. They would hit and beat the children right in front of Zainab alayhi salam, and she could do nothing, because if Hussein, Abbas, the men were killed, only Imam Zainul Abidin was alive, and he was sick, he could not even move. But yet, despite all those tragedies that happened on the day of Ashura and after, Zainab never collapsed. Zainab was so strong. She was as firm as a mountain. And Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam says on a night like this, Sham Ghariban, he says, I saw my aunt Zainab in the middle of the night. She was praying Salat al-Layl. Allahu Akbar. Even on a night like this, when Hussein is killed, Abbas is killed, you're crying for them, the enemies are about to attack, burn the tents, take you as a slave. But yet Zainab still was thinking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She still made time for Salat al-Layl, even at such a night. But Imam Zainul Abidin says that this night, what made it different than any other for Zainab, he says, I saw Zainab, she was praying Salat al-Layl from Julus, meaning she was sitting and praying. So I asked her, my dear Aunt Zainab, why do you not stand up and pray? Why are you sitting and praying? She tells him, my dear nephew, Zain al-Abidin, I have no energy left in me. I can't even stand up. Zainab alayhi salam, because of all the masa'ib that she saw, she had no energy left. Because remember, on top of all of that, Zainab alayhi salam had a job. Zainab alayhi salam had a responsibility that Imam Hussein told her. He brought her to the side before he died. He told her, my dear sister Zainab, after I die, things will get tough. The enemies will hurt you. The enemies will oppress you. But you, Zainab, out of everyone, you have to be strong, because you are the one that I am entrusting my children and all the women with. Zainab, you will have to take care of everyone, because Imam Zainul Abidin is sick. He can't do anything. There's no men besides Imam Zainul Abidin. So all the responsibility was on Zainab to make sure that she has all the orphans, the kids in the tent, none of them get lost, make sure all the women are there. Throughout the trip to Kufa and Sham, it was Zainab alayhi salam that took care of everyone. So she had this responsibility. That was the first responsibility Zainab had. And on top of that, Zainab alayhi salam, her main responsibility was to expose Yazid. Zainab did not stay silent in any station that they moved on. Everywhere they went, Zainab would make sure to expose Yazid. Because remember, Yazid tried to change the true story. He used propaganda, just like we have propaganda today of the state. He used propaganda to tell people that Hussein, who's Hussein and his family? Hussein was a Khariji, he was a kafir that we killed, and these are his family now. We have taken them as prisoners of war. And people believe the story. That's why Imam Zainul Abidin, when they were moving to Sham and Kufa, they come across a village. He sees an old man. Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam asks him about a verse. He asks him, have you heard this verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he speaks about the family of Rasulullah. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. The only thing I ask you, O Muslims, in return for what I have done for you. Rasulullah says this, I did so much for you, O Muslims. I established this religion. I took you out of shirk. I introduced you to Allah. The only thing I ask in return is to love my family. When Imam Zainul Abidin asked him about this verse, the man is surprised. He says, you know the Quran? He's surprised the Imam even knows the Quran. Because what was he brainwashed to believe? That these are all kuffar, non-believers. We went, we had a war with them, and now we have brought them back as prisoners of war. He says, we are the qurba, we are the family of Rasulullah. I don't know the Quran. The Quran was revealed in my grandfather's house. It was revealed upon him. Verses of the Quran speak about Ahlul Bayt. You don't think I know the Quran? So this is what Yazid did, he brainwashed people. So the job of Zainab, everywhere she went, to expose the plot of Yazid, the schemes of Yazid. the game of Yazid, to tell them that this is the son of Rasulullah, Imam Hussein, and he was unjustly killed every station that they went. So it was Zainab that carried the torch of Imam Hussein, that continued the message of Hussein. That's why he took Zainab with him. Why did Hussein take Zainab and the woman with him to Karbala if he knew he was going to get killed? Because he knew he had to have someone to continue that message, to carry the torch, to expose Yazid, to tell the truth. And this is what Zainab alayhi salam did. After the day after Ashura, they rounded up all the family members of Hussein, the woman and the children. They put them on camels, and then they headed to Kufa. The first station was Kufa. When Ahlul Bayt arrived to Kufa, they arrived as prisoners of war. When they entered the city of Kufa, all the heads were on the spears, the heads of Hussein and Abbas and the other companions. And the city of Kufa had a celebration because these are prisoners of war. They took them to the palace of Ibn Ziyad. Ibn Ziyad was the governor of Al-Kufa. They took him to his palace, he was not there. When Zainab arrived, subhanallah, all of a sudden when the people saw the orphans, the children, they saw it's women, there isn't any men, they saw the heads, the people of Al-Kufa began to cry. They began to cry at Zainab and the others. And this is where Zainab gave a beautiful sermon. Wallahi, if you see the sermon of Zainab in Kufa, she had another sermon in Sham in front of Yazid. Many of us have heard of that. But the sermon of Zainab in Al-Kufa was unbelievable. Zainab alayhi salam, she sees the people of Al-Kufa, they started to cry. What did she tell them? She told them, Ya Ahl al-Kufa, Ya Ahl al-Khatli wal-Ghadr. O people of Kufa, O traitors, she calls them traitors. O hypocrites, you cry now? Remember, you sent letters to my brother Hussein, 18,000 letters from al-Kufa, telling Hussein to come to Kufa and we will fight for you. But then you betrayed him, you went to kill him. And that's why when we read the Maqtal, Imam Hussein, he called upon them. If I can please ask the six sisters to quiet down, I can't focus. Please, sallu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Zainab alayhi salam tells them that you're the ones that sent letters to my brother Hussein. Imam Hussein tells them on the day of Ashura, he mentions their names, O Hijr ibn Abjar, O Qais ibn al-Ash'ath. We mentioned it in the Maqtal today. Didn't you write me letters telling me come to Kufa and we'll fight for you? Now you have come to kill me? Now they denied it, they lied, but they did do so. So Zainab says, O traitors, O hypocrites, you sent letters to my brother Hussein, and now you come and you cry. She tells them, فَلَا رَقَأَتِ الدَّمْعَ وَلَا هَدَأَتِ الْعَبْرَ وَالزَّفْرَ. She says, I wish you never stop crying. I wish you die from how much you cry, you hypocrites. They see someone that has the guts, that has the courage to speak in this way. Who is this? It's the daughter of Amir al-Mu'mineen. It is Lady Zainab alayha salam. And then she continues, she says, وَيْلَكُمْ أَتَدْرُونَ أَيَّ كَبِدٍ لِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ فَرَيْتُمْ وَأَيَّ كَرِيمَةٍ لَهُ أَبْرَزْتُمْ وَأَيَّ دَمٍ لَهُ سَفَكْتُمْ وَأَيَّ حُرْمَةٍ لَهُ أَتَكْتُمْ. Woe unto you, O people of Kufa! Do you know what you did to the heart of Rasulullah? Do you know how you've crushed the heart of Rasulullah by what you did? By abandoning Hussein. Imam Hussein sent Muslim ibn Aqil to mobilize those 18,000. How many of them joined Hussein's camp? 1,000? 20? 1-0. They all abandoned Hussein. Do you know what you did by abandoning Hussein, by then going and joining the camp of Yazid to kill him? Because Ibn Ziyad began to pay money, big amounts of money. If you go and fight against Hussein, I'll give you 100 dinars, 500 dinars. And they went. She tells them, do you know how you crushed the heart of Rasulullah by what you did? Do you know what sanctity you have violated? Do you know what type of crime? The greatest crime of all time, you're all accomplice in it. She speaks to the people of Kufa in that way, those hypocrites. And then she says, فَلَقَدْ ذَهَبْتُمْ بِعَارِهَا وَشَنَارِهَا. Shame on you, you disgraceful individuals. She continues to rebuke them. She says, أفعجبتم أن تمطر السماء دما ولعذاب الآخرة أخزى وهم لا ينصر. She says, were you surprised that the skies wept blood? After Imam Hussein died, the sky rained blood for Imam Hussein alayhi salam. The people of Kufa were surprised. She tells them, are you surprised that the sky wept blood for Hussein? She tells them, just wait until you see what Allah does to you in the next life. The adab, the punishment of Allah. This is how you betray my brother Hussein. Nobody came to help Hussein. You betrayed him, you abandoned him. She gives a beautiful khutbah. All of them, they cry. They feel so bad for what they did to Aba Abdullah. After she finishes, Ibn Ziyad comes into the majlis. He comes, he sees Zainab speaking. He says, is this Zainab? They say, yes, this is Zainab, the daughter of Amir al-Mu'mineen. He comes and he begins to taunt Zainab. He comes and he wants to break the heart of Zainab. What does he tell her? He says, Zainab, كيف رأيت صنع الله فيك? He says, الحمد لله الذي كذبكم وقتلكم وأكذب أحدوثتكم. He says, oh Zainab, I praise Allah that Allah exposed you and Hussein and your family. Remember, it's propaganda. Now Zainab has said her side of the story, so the people will believe her. But now Ibn Ziyad, he wants to say his side, the propaganda. So he begins by acting so holy. He says, Alhamdulillah alladhi fadahakum wa qatalakum wa akdhaba uhduthatakum. I thank Allah who exposed you and your plot, and he killed your brothers. He killed the men in your family, and he exposed you. Subhanallah. And this is who's saying this? Ibn Ziyad, that the ahadith we read, Ad-Da'i ibn Ad-Da'i. Ad-Da'i means Ibn Zina. He was an illegitimate child and his father was an illegitimate child. He is that person and he's speaking to Zainab, the pure Zainab, the daughter of Amir al-Mu'mineen and Fatima. He says about her, Alhamdulillah, that God destroyed you and killed you. It's as if they're the evil ones. And then he says after that, he begins to gloat at Zainab. He begins to mock her. He tries to break her heart. He tells her, كيف رأيت صنع الله فيك وفي أهل بيتي وفي أهل بيتك. He tells her, how do you see what Allah, what do you think about what Allah did to you and your family members? What Allah did to you? It's as if this was the plan of Allah and this was what, you know, what should have happened. So he acts once again so righteous, holier than thou. He acts so righteous in front of his people, in front of the people of Kufa. What do you say about what Allah did to you? And he's making fun of her. But this is Zainab, the daughter of Ali. Look at what Zainab answers back. Zainab alayhi salam, she gives the most beautiful answer that remains, that echoes until eternity. What does Zainab say? She says, Wallahi ma ra'aytu illa jameela. Allahu Akbar. She says, I see what Allah did to my brother Hussein as beautiful. Why? Because if this was the plan of Allah, that Allah wanted my brother to become a shaheed, a martyr, then I see it as a beautiful plan. Yes, I cry because I have emotions, but Imam Hussein did the right thing. Don't think that I'm gonna sit and cry until you know it was a bad thing. You guys did a crime. It was horrendous crime. It was vicious. But the plan of Allah that he made my brother shaheed, the fact that my brother gave his blood for Allah, I see it as beautiful. Allahu Akbar. How Zainab has a rida bi qada'illah. She accepts what happens to her and brother Hussein. And then she tells Ibn Ziyad after that, she tells him, Ha'ula qawm katab Allahu alayhim al-qatl fabarazu ila madaji'ihim. Yes, don't think that I don't accept the will of Allah. Allah had written that Hussein and his companions are all shuhada. They die fi sabilillah, for the cause of Allah, and they went to their shahada. That was an honor for Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And then she tells him, that's for Hussein. Hussein, he did what he was supposed to do, what was asked of him from Allah. But for you, O Ibn Ziyad, وَسَيَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُمْ فَتُحَاجْ وَتُخَاصَمْ فَانْظُرْ لِمَنِ الْفَلَجْ يَوْمَئِذٍ. He says, as for you, remember there's a day of judgment. Allah will resurrect you and my brother Hussein, and Allah will punish you for what you did to my brother. And then she tells him, ثَكَلَتْكَ أُمُّكَ يَبْنَ مَرْجَانَ. She says, may you die and your mother grieve over you, O son of Marjana. This is Ibn Ziyad. He was a dictator. No one could speak to him in this way. He sees all of a sudden Zainab is insulting him in this way, disrespecting him. ثَكَلَتْكَ أُمَّكَ. May you die and your mother grieve for you. This is the braveness of, the bravery, the courage of Zainab alayhi salam. She's the daughter of Amir al-Mu'mineen. They saw her eloquence, the beautiful speech that she gave. So Ibn Ziyad, now he saw that he's insulted by a lady, by a woman. So now what does he do? He tries once again to break the heart of Zainab. He tells her, لَقَدْ شَفَى اللَّهُ قَلْبِي لَقَدْ شَفَى اللَّهُ قَلْبِي مِنْ طَاغِيَتِكِ الْحُسَيْنِ وَالْعُصَاتِ الْمَرَدَ مِنْ أَهْلِ بَيْتِكِ. He tells her, he breaks her heart. He tells her, you know what? I feel so good now that God killed your brother Hussein. That was my cure. The death of your brother Hussein and the way he was killed, I feel so good about it. That cured my heart. He's gloating at her. He wants her to feel bad. That while you're mourning and crying, I'm happy and cheering for what happened to your brother Hussein. But Zainab alayhi salam then tells her, she tells him, لَعَمْرِي لَقَدْ قَتَلْتَ كَهْلِي وَقَطَعْتَ فَرْعِي وَاجْتَثَثْتَ أَصْلِي فَإِنْ كَانَ هَذَا شِفَاءُكَ فَقَدْ اشْتَفَيْتَ. She says, oh Ibn Ziyad, Zainab has emotions. When she hears what Ibn Ziyad said, she could not stay quiet. She began to cry and she said, oh Ibn Ziyad, if you're such a man that's so low, where Hussein's death cures you, where Hussein's death brings joy to your heart, if that's how low and wicked you are, then so be it. Then enjoy the death of Hussein, because you have broken my heart. Yes, you have broken my heart. I am strong, but you have broken my heart. She continues so beautifully, and she shakes the throne of this man, this dictator Ibn Ziyad, who no one could look at him, no one could speak to him. But it was Zainab alayhi salam that stood in front of him, that shook the throne of Ibn Ziyad. And then after that, she did the same thing in front of Yazid, the Khalifa. She went in front of him and she said the same thing. She insulted him, she disrespected him. The words of Zainab alayhi salam, so inspiring. Read the khutbah of Zainab in Damascus in front of Yazid. She exposed him in front of everyone. She gave a beautiful sermon in front of Yazid. And then Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam gave a beautiful sermon in front of Yazid. You know, both in Kufa and Sham. Because Lady Zainab was a woman, you know, they thought, as you know, we should leave the woman alone because she's only a lady. Let her, you know, say nonsense. So they allowed her to speak. But then when Imam Zainul Abidin spoke and exposed Yazid, Yazid wanted to kill Imam Zainul Abidin. It was Zainab that protected him and defended him. She told him, this is a young man, you want to kill him? You have no shame? You're the Khalifa, you're the king, and you want to come after my nephew who's sick, who's young, to kill him? In every position, in every stage, it was Zainab alayhi salam that defended and protected the life of Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam. This is the legacy of Zainab, Ummul Masa'ibi. Zainab, I would love to go through the khutbah, the sermon of Zainab and Imam Zainul Abidin in Sham, but I have no time. Inshallah, maybe another opportunity we'll be able to speak about that. But now, I want to speak about Ummul Masa'ibi Zainab. I want you to come to Karbala. Let us remember what Zainab alayha salam had to go through on the day of Ashura. One of the greatest calamities that Zainab alayha salam had to go through on the day of Ashura was that she had to witness her brother Hussein being killed by the enemies. How much can the heart of Zainab bear, brothers and sisters? It was the day of Ashura. Zainab alayha salam knows her brother Hussein is in his final moments. He's surrounded by the enemy. She can't see what's happening because of how many people are surrounding him. So what does Zainab do? Zainab goes on a hill, they call it a Tell al-Zainabi. You can find it till this very day. She goes on a hill so she could see Hussein. What's happening? What does she see? She sees Shimr. Hazrat Zainab alayha salam, Ruza Ashura. Abu Abdullah al-Hussein, Baina Dushmanan, Lahazat Akhara, Imam Hussein. Hazrat Zainab, Mir Rutal Zainabi, Mukhad Babina, Imam Hussein. Zendes, Yomurdes, Yahomi Bina in Malun, Shemr, Miyajalo, Besuya Abi Abdullah. الله الحسین علیه السلام میخواد بعد میخوام برات بخونم زینب چه کار کرد ایوا حسینا ایوا زینبا آن دم بریدم از زندگی دل آن دم بریدم از زندگی دل حضرت زینب میگه کامد به مسلخ شمر سیاه دل کامد به مسلخ شمر سیاه دل ایوا زینبا ایوا زینبا چه کار میکرد؟ امیدوید و من میدویدم شمر امیدوید و من میدویدم سوی مقتل من سوی قاتل سوی مقتل من سوی قاتل همه بگن آه یا زینب آه یا زینب آه یا زینب دیگه برات بخونم او می نشست و من می نشستم او می نشست و من می نشستم کجا؟ او روی سینه من در مقابل او روی سینه سینه امام حسین همه میگن یا حسین یا مظلوم حسین جای حسین جای او می نشست و من می نشستم او روی سینه من در مقابل او می برید و من می بریدم او می برید و من می بریدم او از حسین سر من غیر از او دل او از حسین سر من غیر از او دل آن دم بریدم از زندگی دل کامد به مسلخ شمر سیاه دل آه یا زینب آه یا زینب آه یا زینب زینب آه همه با هم بگن آه یا زینب Sisters, I want you to come with me to Karbala on a night like this. Shama ghariba, ya, ya. I want you to imagine the gloomy, depressing atmosphere in Karbala. Bibi Zainab no longer has any of the men. The women have lost all of the men except Imam Zainul Abideen. And the Imam was all sick in the tent. On a night like this, the women no longer had the men to protect them. On a night like this, they were all alone between the enemies. On a night like this, the women no longer had Aunan Muhammad. On a night like this, the women no longer had Qasim and Akbar. Abu Abdullah al-Hussein was not there to protect the woman. Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas's hands were severed by the Euphrates. Ali al-Asghar was slaughtered right in the hands of his father. Imam Hussein's body lay on the sands of Karbala without any cover. On a night like this, the women are all grieving their loved ones. They had gathered in the tents and they were all crying for the companions of Hussein. One is crying for her father, another for her son, another for her uncle, another for her brother, another for her nephew. All they wanted to do was cry and weep. But all of a sudden, they saw the enemies. They attacked the tents of the women. They came inside. They began to beat the children. They stole everything they could find. They even took the earrings of the little girls. They didn't gently take it, but rather they ripped it off their ears. Aywa Husayna, ya. These girls began to cry and scream, Wa Husayna, Wa Husayna, Wa Dayatana Ba'dak. Oh Hussein, look what's happened to us after you were killed. Now, was that enough? No, they didn't stop there. And this is where Shimr cries out. Shimr, this vicious enemy, he cries out, أَحْرِقُوا بُيُوتَ الظَّالِمِينَ عَلَىٰ رُؤُوسِهِمْ. Burn down the tents on the ظَالِمِينَ. And he calls Ahlul Bayt the ظَالِمِينَ, the oppressors. They come, they begin to tour, they begin to burn the tents. These little girls, they don't know what to do. Their only safe place was the tent. But now the tents are burning. They start screaming and shouting. They come to Zainab. What do we do? Zainab alayha salam doesn't know what to tell them. She goes to Imam Zain al-Abideen alayha salam. She tells him, my dear nephew, ya thimal al-baqin, ya baqiyat al-madin, ya Zain al-Abideen, laqad ahraqu khiyamana. They have burned the tents. What do we do? Where do we go? Imam Zainul Abideen tells her, my dear Aunt Zainab, run away and tell the girls to run out of the tent. This is when all those little girls, the orphans, they began to run out of the tent. They went inside the valley of Karbala in the middle of the night. While they were crying, Wa Muhammada, Wa Aliya, Wa Fatimata, ya, ya, ya.
Hamid ibn Muslim, he's one of the narrators that was there. He says, I noticed that amongst the girls that were running away from the fire was a little girl. Her dress was on fire and she was running and screaming. He says, she broke my heart. I went after her to turn off the fire. She was afraid that I was there to hurt her. But then when I caught up to her, I told her, my dear girl, please don't be afraid because I only want to help you. I turned off the fire. After that, she asked me, have have you read the Quran, oh Shaykh? I said, yes, I have read the Quran. Why do you ask about the Quran? She told me, oh Shaykh, have you read this verse? فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ. As for the yatim, the orphan, don't bother them. He said, yes. She told me, oh Shaykh, أَنَا يَتِيمَةُ الْحُسَيْنِ هَمَا بِكَ أَنْ مَظْلُوم حُسَيْنِ غَرِيب حُسَيْنِ. She tells him, I am the orphan of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn. He asks her, do you want anything? Please ask me anything. She tells him, ya Shaykh, I have not had water for such a long time. I am dying of thirst. He tells her, yes, my dear girl, come to the water. He takes her to the river and he gives her water. She takes the water, she wants to drink it, but all of a sudden she stops and she takes the water back. She tells him, he tells her, didn't you tell me you're thirsty? Why do you not drink? Aywa Husayna, listen to the answer. She says, how can I drink when Husayn died thirsty? Even the little girls, the kids, they could not drink water when they knew Husayn died out of thirst. When they did not give any water to Husayn. Aywa Husayna, aywa mazluma. Aywa Husayna. Misleha min shabud, sham ghariban bud. Bibi Zainab miguyad ke man dombal hame yatima armalha budam ke gom nashan, mafqud nashan. گفت همشون را شماردم دیدم یکی مفقوده یکی کمه. رفتم گشتم دیدم کی کمه. دیدم که رباب مادر علی اصغر نیست تو جمع تو خیمه نیست. میگه انقدر گشتم رباب کجایی؟ رباب نبود. میگه خدایا رباب کجاست؟ تو خیمه نبود. زینب میگه از خیمه خارج شدم ربام کجا رفته؟ گفت رفتم بیرون، رفتم به سوی قتلگاه، دیدم یک خانومی اونجا نشسته بین شهدا، بین بدنهای شهدا نشسته تنها. رفتم نگاه کردم دیدم این ربابه نشسته تنها. دوباره نگاه کردم دیدم یه چیزی بغلش گذاشته، بغل کرده. گفت دوباره نگاه کردم دیدم یه بدن بچه 6 ماهه، اما سر نداشت، بی سر بود. اومدم گفتم عزیزم رباب، چرا اینجا اومدی؟ چرا این بچه را بغل کردی؟ نمیدونم دل داری اینو بشنوی یا نه، برای مادرها که بچه دارن. ربام گفت عزیزم زینب، روز عاشورا آب نداشتم، روز عاشورا آب نخوردم، شیر هم نداشتم به این بچه شیر بدم، اما الان که آب خوردم شیر دارم، اومدم به علی اصغر شیر بدم. همه بگن مظلوم حسین، غریب حسین، عطشان حسین. أسألك اللهم وندعوك باسمك العظيم الأعظم الأعز الأجل الأكرم. هم أبو هم everyone 10 times. يا الله يا الله يا الله. يا الله يا الله يا الله يا الله.
Brothers and sisters, many have asked me to recite dua for sick individuals in this community. We have certain people who need your dua. They are in a desperate condition and they need our dua, and in other places, other communities. So let us please recite this verse 5 times, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them the shifa, to give them the cure, insha'Allah, with the blessings of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Amman yujibul muttarra idha da'a wa yakshifu as-su'. أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء. اللهم اشفي كل مريض. اللهم ارزقنا في الدنيا زيارة الحسين وفي الآخرة شفاعة الحسين. اللهم اقضي حوائجنا، عجل في فرج صاحب الزمان، واجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه والمستشهدين بين يديه، وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات، لا سيما إلى روح آية الله ساجدي، نهدي لهم جميعا ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلوات.